this and our own blessing to now.
Amen, amen.
Just to be supportive in what he's saying, he really missed something very important. At the time that he got his salary cut over $1,700 a month, I didn't even know anything about that cut coming. And I just changed jobs and took a cut from like 20 bucks an hour down to 10 just to get my foot in the door of this job. So he had to be stressed with knowing that I'm getting this tremendous cut, and he also had this tremendous cut coming. So it was a very stressful time, but it was so enlightening because we saw the Lord move in our lives. And again, we didn't have to cut our tithing, but we did have to learn how to live within what we had. And after time went by, like you said, here we are a year down the line, and I've learned how to do something I never knew to do, which started with cutting out coupons to you name it. It wasn't just a walk in the park. You know, we had still had bills to pay. And the Lord still provided.
Amen.
That's the bottom line. The Lord still provided. And as he said, they told him his salary would never be restored. Well, it got restored.
Praise God. That's the God we serve.
Yes, it got restored. And from my $10 an hour job that I started, even with the same company, it makes me smile because I went from there, getting my foot into the door to that new job. Mm-hmm. As I had been a dental assistant for 25 years, and I started teaching. Mm-hmm. Never taught before in my life. And I said, you know, to take a part-time job at $10 an hour when I had made really good money was just real scary. And he was afraid to tell me that he was also losing $1,700 a month at the same time. But God provided.
Yes,
I went from that $10 an hour to managing a dental program and as program director and dental instructor, I ended up doubling, if not more, that salary that I started out with. So just to share that with you. And it is important.
That part I really meant to tell you about, you know, because that's important. They had told us that our salary wouldn't be restored, and to show you how the Lord works, it was close to a year, and you would think that the city council, Los Angeles City Council, would have nothing to do with our salary, you know, but they passed a LA City Council passed an ordinance that pertained to all the employees at LAX. And most of our income was restored because of the law that the City Council passed. And then right after that, because of that law, because of what they had to restore, then we had a raise that was coming from our contract, that because of our money had been restored, then they had to give another raise on top of that, and all of it was restored except our $200 a month. And it's offering time. And Heavenly Father,
thank you.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to give, Heavenly Father. And I thank you and we pray for each one that has an offering to give. And I pray a special blessing for the ones that have it on their minds to give and are unable to, Heavenly Father. And Father, we thank you for this opportunity. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. we'd like to just thank you for this opportunity to give to your people. Heavenly Father, these funds are to be used to enhance your kingdom in a way that is honorable and just what you believe you want us to be doing. Heavenly Father, the Holy Spirit continue to reign over this church and over this body. We know that there are those here who want to give and are not able to give, but your blessings go out to them as well, Father. Father, we receive these blessings in love. We just pray that we continue to grow as a church. In the name of Jesus, we pray.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Very nice, Pastor.
Amen. Amen. We have had a great time thus far. Amen. We're going to conclude this great service through our communion time, giving our thanks, the Eucharist, coming together, amen, to break the bread, drinking of the juice representing his shed of blood and the bread of his body. The Bible says, often as you do this,
we show forth his death until he returns. It is so easy to forget where we come from and the blessings of life through the blood of Jesus Christ. And so every first Sunday, we at Greater Faith Grace Bible Church, we come to remind ourselves that the Lord is going to come back one day. As the choir sang earlier, will you be ready when the Lord returns? And so we take communion, we're doing it too, that we're looking back at his death on the cross. And we're looking forward to his return. Paul, the Apostle Paul, makes it very plain in the book of 1 Corinthians. He says that he that eateth drinketh unworthily drinketh damnation of his own soul. If we take this cup here and this bread without the inner conviction in our hearts that Jesus Christ is God's Son, that he died on the cross of Calvary 2,000 years ago, that he was buried and rose again, and believe in our heart that though no man knows the day or the hour, but thanks be to God, he gave us some clues. He gave us some indicators that he's going to come back again. The clues and indicators are all around us. And we stand today and say, God, with this communion, with this bread, with this cup, I'm once again reminded of my deep inner convictions. First of all, that Jesus Christ died for my sins. All of them. Past, present, and future. He is the only way to salvation. And I also believe that he's going to come back again for the church. The believers come back and reign again. And with those thoughts in my heart, I partake of this communion. This time we have our prayer for the bread and for the drink. Heavenly Father, as we partake of this bread,
yes, Lord Jesus,
I pray, Heavenly Father, that it will show. I pray, Heavenly Father.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
That it will show from the offering of my heart, Heavenly Father, the commitment, to live for our Lord and Savior Jesus, who died for us.
Heavenly Father, with this drink we commune together in celebrating and remembering the greatest sacrifice ever
made. Yes, Lord, yes.
The blood of Jesus Christ was given and he died for all of our sins. Father, we just continue just to say thank you. Thank you for your mercy and thank you for your grace, everybody. Us all, a gateway to enter into your kingdom. In the name of Jesus, amen.
And now, our deacons and ministers will serve the body of Christ. Will serve the body of Christ with love and joy. What a blessing it is to serve
body of Christ. What a blessing it is. Continue year by year, make perfect those who draw near. Otherwise, would they not have ceased to be offered? Because the worshippers, having once been cleansed, will no longer have conscience of sins. But in those sacrifices, there is a reminder of sins year by year. But is it possible for the blood of bulls and goats to take away sins? Therefore, when he comes to the world, he says, sacrifice offerings you have not desired, but a body prepared for me. And whole burnt offerings and sacrifice for sin, you have taken no pleasure. Then I said, behold, I have come, and the scroll of the book it is written of me. To do your will, O God, after saying above, sacrifice offerings, and whole burnt offerings and sacrifices for your sins you have not desired, nor have you taken pleasure in them which offered according to the law. Then he said, behold, I have come to do your will. He takes away the first or to establish the second. By this will we have been sanctified, the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. Every priest stands daily ministering and offering time after time the same sacrifice, which can never take away sins. But he, having offered one sacrifice for sins for all time, sat down at the right hand of God, waiting for the time onward until his enemies were made a footstool for his feet. For by one offering, he has perfected all time those who are sanctified. And the Holy Spirit also testifies us after the same. This is the covenant that I will make with them. After those days, says the Lord, I will put my laws in their heart, and on their mind I will write them. He then says, and their sins and their lawless deeds I will remember no more. Now, when it's forgiveness of these things, there is no longer any offering for sin. Hebrews 10, verses 1 through 18. Offering for sin once and forever. Symbol of Christ offering for our sin once and forever. Remind you once again. Assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled clean from evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, But he who promised is faithful. He has promised that our sins are forgiven by his precious blood. He has promised he'll come back for the church that's spot or wrinkle. And with his promise and full assurance, let us eat and drink in confidence of God's word. Now if you pass your cup to the center aisle, our deacons will receive them. Before we dismiss here, there's food ministry that's coming up Saturday. Amen. There is Sunday school classes next Sunday at 9 a.m. in the morning. Praise God. Come to that right there. Praise God. Amen. And also make sure you get enrolled for Vacation Bible School. Get enrolled for Vacation Bible School. Everybody get enrolled and get signed up. Amen. Get signed up, amen. Praise be to God, amen. What a blessing, praise God, amen. Make sure if I do get signed up, amen. And we thank God for the men that worked very hard getting that room taken care of back here. And we thank God for that all. What a great blessing, amen. And please, make sure you invite and invest someone to come to church, amen. Invite and tell someone to come to church. And also in the back here, there's some flyers about a Vacation Bible School. Take some flyers. And please get them handed out so you can tell folks to come out to Vacation Bible School. Start for 3 more weeks. We're going to have an exciting time, a journey off the map, amen. To God be the glory, amen. For a great, great time, amen.
What's your team?
I want to remind you on second Saturday about how our and let us get excited about it. It's a project that we need to improve our church. We're going to raise money for our fences. And also, I need help. I'm in charge of the grounds. I need help. We're trying to get our memorial thing done. We have a committee on that. But any male or female would like to come Saturday and assist us in improving our church, it would be greatly appreciated. Let us bring our card. If you don't have a card, let's give a donation. And I guarantee you, God will bless you. Give it from your heart, and God will bless you. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Now, before we close, I feel so blessed today. I'm so blessed today. I want to introduce the Greater Big Grace Bible Church. My very, very first son in the ministry.
Amen.
Eric Palmer. We were our first ministry life at Greater Faith Grace Bible Church in Riverside, California, amen.
Amen.
And he was also our very, very first youth pastor at Greater Faith Grace Bible Church, amen. Over 30 some odd years ago.
Wow.
So I introduce you guys today, Reverend Eric Holmes.
Yeah.
Moved to been in the military. He now lives in Killeen, Texas, amen. And he's been out watching us on live streaming. Thank God for that, amen. And he told me previously, he said, when I'm in the area, I'm going to make sure I come by and say hello to the Risen Church Home, Greater Faith Grace Bible Church.
Amen.
And when I saw you come, it would just touch my heart such a special way, Reverend Holmes, amen, to know that I was able to play a small part in your life, your ministry. And still follow the Lord Jesus Christ, amen. And I just thank God, amen, that God has, even all these years of being suffering, amen, getting through social media, we're able to connect back again through Facebook, social media, amen. So again, for the home, I am just. Good coming home not as a problem, but as a child of God. That's the good part, amen.
Amen.
So not so good on the
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Say amen again.
Amen.
I did tell him online that I'm going to bring my children. I have my son. He's up in Trinidad right now. My daughter's at home with my... she's at home. So I'm out here celebrating with my family the holidays. And I wanted to come out here to everybody out here. Yes, I am in Texas. Been out there for quite a while now. Born and raised here in California. I know it don't look like it, but I just turned 50. served in the military 22 years. And as I told him, while serving in the military, I was able to actually sit with the Iraqi people. With that, you know, they learned about Jesus. I learned about Allah. You know, and the thing is I converted more of them than they converted me. There's something about the name of Jesus. While in Texas, I told the pastor that I am now under the Bishop T.D. Jakes. I saw the young lady's Bible. I am under the Bishop T.D. Jakes. So, and I'm learning so much, you know, but this will always be home.
Amen.
Whenever you need me, just give me a call. Right?
Amen.
All
right. Amen. 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 Missing you again really, really soon. It's a blessing when I just so blessed by this. What a blessing, amen. And when I talked on the phone a few weeks ago, I said, you know, several years ago, his family, I gave one of my very first plaques, and right now, it's still in my office right now. In fact, it was a special day, and I thank God for that plaque right there. So 30 years old, it's still hanging on. I look at that plaque on the home. I said, again, thank you, Brother Holmes. Praying with you, praying for you. Thank you again for just being in our presence. Amen. Let us stand. Jesus Christ is alive, he's real, and he's still saved to uttermost, and we need him so much. Now, Lord God, bless us and keep us, and may all of God's people say together. Hug your neighbors, remind you, follow God, he's a mighty good leader.